In 2011, the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department reopened the investigation of Natalie Wagner Wood and her drowning death. As a result of these efforts, witnesses were identified in 2011 and 2012 that weren't previously known. This case remains a suspicious circumstances death, and the information that came forward in 2011 and 2012 has helped present a more articulate timeline in this case.
We've interviewed a lot of new people, and people on the island, people who were moored near the boat that night or that weekend, people who had knew the couple or had knowledge of what was going on that weekend. So it's been extremely helpful in recreating what happened. There's actually more than one witness and who came forward and heard them on the back of the boat arguing. And and what's important about that is they corroborate what Dennis DeVerne was saying, that he was on the boat and heard the arguing, and that it was really intense and that so bad that he had went down to the cabin to check on them because he was worried that there was some kind of assault going on. And that's when he was told to go away by Robert Wagner. And then Natalie and Robert Wagner end up on the back of the boat arguing, and then it goes quiet. So those witnesses who were on a different boat nearby corroborate exactly what Dennis DeVerne was telling us. And yes, of course, we want to talk to Robert Wagner, you bet. We would love to hear his side of his version of events. We were able to recreate the timeline and get it down to where he was the last person with her on the back of the boat arguing before everything went quiet. And then next thing you know, Dennis DeVerne comes down to check on what happened. And there's Robert Wagner in the salon of the boat. He's saying Natalie's gone. She's missing. I can go on and on, but yeah, it just didn't add up.